Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tony D'Angelo, and welcome to my home. Today on Cooking for Men, we are going to do a viewer request. I apologize for being absent last week, but I had some family business we had to attend to in the old country. That's right, I had to go spend a week in New Jersey. Well, while I was up there, I had the good fortune to have dinner with some very good, dear old friends. And as often happens, they ordered some appetizers, and one of the appetizers they ordered was deep-fried pickles. So continuing our salute to deep fryers, today we're going to do deep-fried pickles. It's kind of a funny little story. We're sitting around drinking a couple of beers there at the local pub, and one of the fellow's wives just hauls off and hits me on the arm, just nails me. And I said, what was that about? You know, I'm thinking she remembered something from high school. And she says, you know, my husband watches your videos, takes notes, and then goes and trashes my kitchen, and then is completely proud of his efforts and wants a reward. Please explain to him that's not the way you do it. So I looked across the table at my old buddy, kind of looked down, ate a pickle, looked up at him, looked at her. Yeah, you guessed it. I said, hey, thank you for watching. We love you guys. And of course, she hit me again. But anyways, let's take a quick rundown of these ingredients for deep-fried pickles. And I promise next week we will do the Twinkie and the Snickers bar, and that will conclude our deep-fryer series. Okay, fellas, this is a relatively simple recipe. What we're going to need is some type of container that we can bread the pickles in. I like to use an empty, cleaned-out peanut butter jar. You can use Tupperware, whatever you like. Into that, we're going to add just about 1/8 teaspoon of salt, not much. And about 1 cup of flour. Now these are the only, we're gonna need some more flour. Okay, like I said, 1 cup of flour. This is regular bread flour and some whole wheat mixed in. You don't need much. Now, these are the only two ingredients that are mandatory. You can add or subtract from this whatever you like. You can use crushed pepper if you want. I like some black pepper. You can use hot sauce, whatever you want. Tap that. Give it a pre-shake. Okay, now, we've given this a nice shake so it's mixed up. What we're going to do now is remove some pickles and let them pre-drain. We just have a little baking deal set up here. A little rack. And that's plenty. You don't want to put them when they're too wet right into the batter, because then the batter gets all lumpy. And we've already washed our hands. Toss some pickles in there. Okay, we just roll it around until we're pretty sure they're completely covered. In a few minutes. And dump them out. We've got our oil heated up over there about 350, 375. Now notice we're dropping these in here like this, instead of over the oil. We want the excess flour to fall off not in our oil. That oil is almost $20 a gallon. We're using peanut oil. And with the proper techniques, you can get quite a bit of life out of them. You don't want to overload your basket, because then this stuff sticks together. I'll tell you, that was hilarious, that dinner. I wish you all could have been there. You know, it's funny, you just, some things you can't make up. It's just, life is just, it's a trip. Okay, we've gotten all our pickles out of there. Shaking off the excess. Okay, fellas, what we're going to do is one basket at a time. Drop them in there for about 3 minutes. We're not going to do both baskets because the temperature will drop too quick and the stuff won't cook as well. And about a minute and a half in, we're just going to give it, we lift it out a little bit and give it a gentle shake to separate them. You'll know they're about done when they start to float on top. We've had a lot of fun with this deep fryer, considering we only paid $5 for it and a couple hours to clean it. Okay, it's been approximately 3 minutes, so we're going to lift this basket up and drop the second basket. You don't want to put all your pickles in one basket, because then they'll just stick together and they won't be very tasty. I kind of have to wonder who invented the deep fried pickle. The first time I ever had it was at a Hooters restaurant, and it was great. But I kind of figured that it was an accidental thing, you know, somebody was reaching over the deep fryer with a bucket of pickles, and history is made, as they say. And feel free to add additional seasonings to this. Old Bay works really well. Garlic powder works really well. Whatever you happen to fancy will work just fine. Okay, that one's been about 3 minutes. Now what we've done here is we have replaced our paper towel with a fresh paper towel and got rid of all that flour, and we're just going to let those sit on there and dry. You know, let some of that excess oil wick up. And we let this sit in the resting position on the fryer for about 2 minutes. Well, there you have it, boys and girls. Breaded deep fried pickles. This is definitely one of those dishes that tastes better than it looks. Okay. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Breaded deep fried pickles. Next week, I promise we will do the Snickers and Twinkie, the original request that got this started. If I could just take a second here and thank all of those people out there that have supported and loved me over the years. We do this for you. Without your support, we would not be able to make the donations we make, and we would not have had nearly as much fun. I'd also like to apologize to any wives whose husbands have watched the videos and trashed the kitchen. Their heart's in the right place. Sometimes we get so busy living, we forget to find the joy that is in our everyday life. Thank you all very much. God bless. And remember, even tough guys can cook. Like the new shirt?